So today, I will explain to you guys how to calculate the amortization using the effective interest method. So we will straightforward to the questions. So the questions state that on the 1st January, Kurte Berhad has issued 50,000 units of bond with the $100 per par value. So the coupon rate of the bond will be 7% and the market rate will be 9%. And the maturity date of the bond is 4 years. And the interest will be paid annually. So the question required us to calculate the amount received by Kurte Berhad on 1st January and show the schedule for bond payment until the maturity date by using effective rate method. So for the first requirement, we have to find whether the bond is issued at discount or premium. So in this case, the bond will be issued at discount because the coupon rate is lower than market rate. So we have to find the exact amount of discount to know how much money that company received at the issued date. So the first step, we have to find the interest by using the coupon rate. So the bond amount will be multiplied by 7%, that equal to $350,000 per year. So next step will be to find annuity payment for the bond. This is when we have to refer annuity table with the interest x percent. So when I check the annuity table, the amount will be 3.312. So the total interest payment until the maturity date is 1,159,200. So in this case, we know that the total of interest payment will be 1,159,200. So next, we will proceed to find the present value of the bond, which is we have to refer to the present value table with the effective rate 8% and the number of period 4 years. So it will be 0.735 based on the present value table. So present value of the bond will be $5 million multiplied by the 0.735 is equal to the $3,675,000. So done with that, we have to calculate the total issuance of bond, which is present value of the bond plus with the total interest of the bond. So the total issuance will be $4,834,200. So done with that, we have to find the discount amount of the bond. So to find the discount, we have to minus the face value of the bond with the total issuance of the bond. So the answer will be 165,800. So it will be known as the discount of the bond. So for the last step, we have to record the journal entry. So debit cash, 4,834,200, and debit discount on bond, which is 165,800, and credit bond payable $5 million. So if you follow all this step, you can actually find the value and actually record the journal entry very easily. So next, to solve the second requirement, which is to show the schedule for the bond payment until maturity date by using effective rate method. So we have to construct the table with 6 columns and 6 rows to record the payment until 2018, which is on the maturity date. So first, we have to start by date column, cash payment bond interest by 8% on market rate, discount amortized, unamortized discount, and carrying amount. So for the 1st January 2015, we know that the interest will be paid around $350,000 per year. So the amount of cash payment will be the same until the maturity date, which is $350,000. So for the unamortized discount, amount will be from the discount amount that we have calculated before. So unamortized discount is 165,800. So next, the carrying amount also will be the total issuance or the cash received that we had from the previous calculation. So check back your working to solve this question. So first, we have to start with 31st December 2015. So the first step, we have to calculate the bond interest. I had labeled it as B. So for this step, we have to multiply the carrying amount or E with 8%, which is market interest rate. So the answer will be $386,736. So it will be the total interest for that period. So next, we have to calculate the discount amortized. To calculate the amortization of the discount, we have to minus B with A, which is bond interest and cash payment. So we can get $36,736. So next step, we have to calculate the unamortized discount amount, which is D column. So to calculate D, we have to minus the previous unamortized discount with the amortized discount. So this step will let us know the balance of discount amount in future. So the discount amount balance will be $129,064. So the last step is to calculate the carrying amount at 31st December 2015. To calculate that, we have to plus the previous carrying amount with the discount that have been amortized. So it will be E plus C that can mean it become $4,870,936. So the carrying amount will keep increasing until the maturity date. So the journal entry at 31st December 2015 will be debit interest expense, credit discount on bond, and credit cash. This is to record the interest payment at 31st December 2015. So continue with year 2016 and 2017. Take your time to calculate it, and you can always pause the video and I will show you the solution on both years to help you to check your answer.
A few moments later.
So for the last year, all the steps will be the same, but for the unamortized discount, we have to put it as zero. If you check the answer will be some point number, right? But the thing is, on the maturity date, the discount amount have to be zero. So why the unamortized discount have to be a zero? It is because we can show that we have amortized all the discount amount, so there will be no any other discount amount that we have to amortize in future. So for the discount amortized column, you can just copy the previous amount of unamortized discount on 2017. So the answer will be $46,540. So the goal is to get total $5 million on the maturity date as the carrying amount, which is the original amount of the bond without any discount at all. So for the general entry on the maturity date, we have to pay the interest and also record the bond redemption. So the general entry to record the interest is the same as previous years. So debit interest expense, credit discount on bond, credit cash. So for the bond redemption, we have to record debit bond, credit cash for $5 million at 31st December 2018. So we officially finish these questions, and I hope you can do this question in future. So that's all from me. Thank you for watching. Please click subscribe button, like and share my video. Thank you everyone. Have a good day.